Hi, this is Julie Dawn Cole, better known as Veruca Salt from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, and you're watching Beyond the Marquee. What happened to all those wonderful magical props? Well, there were a few golden tickets circulating. I do still have one, and I'm not parting with that. I have a scrumdiddlyumptious bar. Well, at least I have the wrapper because I ate the chocolate that was inside it. I still have my original shooting script, and I still have the book that was signed by all the cast members and given to me when I was 12 by my mother. What happened to the fur coat? I have no idea, but I promise you, I haven't got it. What's still out there? I know the everlasting gobstopper, which was mine, is out there somewhere. And I believe there's the key to the inventing room is out there too somewhere. And the riverboat, the Wonkatania, that's somewhere too, but I believe it turned up in a San Francisco car showroom for a while. This is probably one of the craziest things, but here we do have... And that's me. So all sorts of strange things turn up. I haven't as yet signed a golden egg, but I'm waiting.
Hi, I'm Denise Nickerson, and I was lucky enough to play Violet in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Let's see, one of my most favorite scenes was, of course, when I blew up into the blueberry. They had me in a gigantic styrofoam ball cut in half, and they had cut my body out like you'd stencil your hand, and I was cut out in the middle and put together in the two halves like an Oreo, or a Blueio, I suppose. So then they put blue makeup on me, and everyone went to lunch, and Mel Stewart, the director, assigned a man to roll me 180 degrees every 5 minutes. So I'd hang like this and I'd hang like that because it was too long to put me back in it. Standing at the top of those stairs as a 13-year-old girl, just absolutely breathtaking. Nothing that you guys see could ever match my memories.
Hi, I'm Paris Themmen. I played Mike TeeVee and Willy Wonka in the Chocolate Factory. I didn't keep my cap guns, I didn't keep my hat, I didn't keep my jacket, I didn't keep, you know, anything, basically. I had my script for a while. And so as far as props and that sort of thing, to me it's a bit of a sore point. I wish especially I'd kept a golden ticket. I know that one went on auction for something like $50,000 recently, and wouldn't that have been nice? This room had a lot of great stuff in it. This is the inventing room. The thing that I liked, of course, was the exploding gum, which was like a sort of a tube that they ran here, and I blew and the smoke came out, and they had a wire attached to my belt. So they yanked me back into the pots and pans and I fell. And of course, to me as an 11-year-old, that was a stunt. They had real pots and pans made out of copper behind me. And I was like, let's do it again. And they said, no, no, I think we've got it, you know. Ours was made for $1 million or $2. It wasn't meant to be a huge success. You know, they always want everything to succeed, but it wasn't, like I say, their big blockbuster of the summer or anything like that. It was just a film, a small kids film, and then it became popular when they showed it on TV every year for Thanksgiving and things like that. So I don't think that they had the forethought to archive everything for our film. Look at who's tapping. It's Veruca Salt. What's up? You need me to take a photo? Oh, here's Violet. Okay, so I'm gonna say goodbye, but yeah, exactly. You get me going and I'll talk.
Thank you.
See ya. You know what I say sometimes is that I'm a walking, talking, living, breathing prop. So when people are like, oh, you didn't keep any of the props? It's like, you know, this is, that's it. This is the prop. That's all you get.
And within 24 hours, they had to use food dye in the makeup. So my neck, my face, my ears, and my hands were turning bright blue. And I had frantically washed it off with soap, and it would resurface again.
If you liked what you saw on this episode, be sure to follow us on our official YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/Beyond the Marquee Show. We're also on Facebook at facebook.com/Beyond the Marquee. And follow our tweets at twitter.com/Beyond Marquee. Thanks for watching.